Hello, friends. Welcome back to Sunday Stories. So today we get to celebrate a really special day in the church. It's Ascension Sunday. And today we get to tell the whole story of the Ascension, which is so fun. Okay, so we are going to be talking about the story from the Acts of the Apostles, which is our first reading. So back up here for a minute. So we have the Gospels, right? And we have four Gospel writers, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So Luke wrote one of the Gospels that tells so much of the story of the life of Jesus. So Jesus dies, he rises again, right? And then sometimes I think he just was gone at that point. That's what we think, but that's not true. He actually came back to earth and spent time with the disciples and like really worked in their hearts and prepared them for this ministry that was to come. And he was there for 40 days after he rose from the dead. And so, but he told them during this time, he said, I'm going to leave you. And remember last week we talked about the Holy Spirit, and he said, I'm going to leave you, but I'm going to leave you with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, it's almost better that I leave. Like, it's almost better that you don't have me right next to you, because the Holy Spirit is so powerful. You're going to want this, I promise. And so can you imagine though, how can the Holy Spirit be better than actually walking with Jesus and seeing him every day? That's the power of the Holy Spirit that's living within you. And he says to him, to them, when I leave, I want you to be disciples to all the nations. I want you to tell this story to anyone who will listen to you all over the world. Because right now, it's just a story that's inside Jerusalem, inside, you know, the Holy Land, Israel, that area of the world. But soon he wants it to spread the entire world. And so the Acts of the Apostles is kind of like part two to the Gospels. So Luke is now telling the story of what happened after Jesus is gone. And so he starts it with the story of the Ascension. So all of the disciples are gathered together and Jesus is speaking to them. And I wonder what that was like. Do you think they knew something momentous was about to happen? Do you think they could like feel it in the air of like, oh, something powerful is going to happen? Do you think maybe they could see it on his face of like maybe excitement, maybe a little bit of sadness that he's leaving them? I don't know. I don't know if they were completely shocked or if they kind of thought, I should pay attention. Something amazing is about to happen. And so while he's standing there looking at them and speaking to them, suddenly he's lifted up. And I kind of picture it like he just gently floats up into the heaven and they're standing there and they're looking up at him. And I mean, they must be in shock. They must be in awe. You know, they might, some of them may have fallen to their knees in reverence and honor, but they don't know what to do. And they're just standing there and they're watching and he disappears from their sight and they stay there. And they keep watching. When you stay there, keep watching. Like if he comes back, I don't want to miss what's about to happen. And so they're standing there and they're waiting. And then suddenly an angel appears. And the angels come down and they say, why are you looking up at the heavens? Don't just stand here. Don't look up at the sky. You have been given a mission. Go. Do your mission. Be disciples to the nations. This whole thing didn't just happen for you guys. This happened so that the entire world would know God. The entire world would be converted to the heart of the Father. And that is your job. And now it is time for you to go out and make disciples to all nations. Did you know that you're called to make disciples too? You're called to talk about Jesus everywhere you go and to whoever you can. Now, I wouldn't just, you know, automatically tell everybody, you need to go to church. But you can talk about how much you love God. You can talk about how much you love going to church. You can ask questions. Hey, do you know Jesus? And you get to be a disciple to the people around you. You can be a disciple to your family members. Some of the best ways to bring people into the faith is when a family member really lives out the faith well. When they see something different and set apart in you, they see, oh, there's something special. When I first became Catholic, my family wasn't Catholic, but I had such a huge conversion. So much changed in me personally that the people around me started to notice and they started to think, I don't know what's different about her, but I want some of it too. And then my mom became Catholic. Isn't that cool? It can happen for you too. All right, guys. I hope you enjoy today. It is a celebration. It is a party. It is a solemnity in the church. So have fun. Maybe even ask your parents if you can have some ice cream or something. You can have Ascension Sundays where you make sundaes and maybe put some like blue or white for the clouds in the sky. Parents are all mad at me right now. It's okay. You can have fun today. All right. Bye, guys.